you're going to be standing before an angry God because you rejected his son, and he's going to reject you. How is your relationship with Christ? Is it alive? Is it vibrant? Is it up to date? Or has it grown cold like the church is in Revelation? Oh yeah, the churches were doing everything they were supposed to do, except Laodicea. They were looking like they were a real church, but they lost their first love. We cannot lose our first love. It's a good time to evaluate your relationship, to evaluate your spiritual condition. What I want to make a point of today, we all need to remember this. If you don't hear anything else that I've said, I want you to hear this. Remember that God is kind, loving, and merciful. Yes, he is. But he is not soft. He will not wink at sin. He will not let you slip by. He will not change. He hates sin. He always will hate sin. And he will always punish sin.
Amen.
But right now, he loves every one of us abundantly. Because he wants us to spend eternity with him. And he's offering up to us his son. The scriptures say, if you call upon the name of the Lord, you will be saved. And if you believe and you are saved, the Father will give to you the Holy Spirit to help you grow and mature and become like Jesus. The judgment will not be a celebration for all. I see all the jokes. Well, not all of them. Some of them are pretty raunchy places. But there's a lot of them that think that hell's going to be a big party because all our friends are going to be there. Well, that might be true. Your friends may all be there, but you're not going to know it because you're going to be all alone. Hell is total darkness, total suffering, total lostness, total without God. And he is the light, and there will be no light. Don't think you'll get by going to hell and you'll enjoy it, because you won't. It's not a celebration for all. Only the redeemed believers who are in right relationship with their Heavenly Father will join in that celebration. And the scriptures indicate to us what kind of a celebration that's going to be. Now, your choice and mine, celebrating in heaven with everybody else, or wandering in hell by myself, by yourself, why didn't I believe?
Amen.
Blunt, hard. Yes. I am an evangelist. This is what I do. I go into churches and I shake them up. And God evidently says, I want you to shake up this church. Preach this. So I did.
Praise God.
Folks, only you know what your relationship is with Jesus. Well, he knows. But only you know whether you need to make something right, you need to forgive, you need to go deeper, you need to acknowledge him as Lord and Savior. Before we get to Easter Sunday and Easter Sunday communion, it is my prayer that we would come to the table of the Lord all in right relationship with him.
Amen.
I don't refuse anyone communion. Never have, never will. But I will warn everyone, do not take communion and not have a relationship with Christ, because you are denigrating the ritual of his death and resurrection for you. And you are told by the scriptures, do not take it in an unworthy manner. We've got today, next week, Palm Sunday, another week, Easter Sunday. That's a long time, people. Get it right. Get it right. Would you stand? Heavenly Father, in the quietness of this moment, I pray for your Holy Spirit to move among us. And if necessary, Lord, I pray that the Holy Spirit would stick a finger in our back to nudge us that there's something wrong. There's something that God wants to heal. There's something God wants to change. Holy Spirit, I pray that you would bring such conviction that we would be so miserable and uncomfortable until it's made right. Ladies and gentlemen, if there is a need for this altar and prayer time, you are more than welcome to come. No music. No singing, just you and the Lord. We won't tarry long, because they have to change the sanctuary over. Thank you, Lord. Lord, I ask your blessing upon these folks, these who are your people, your church. I pray that you would abide closely with them, fill them, love them, keep them moving forward. Lord, as we conclude this service and we prepare for the next fellowship, may your Holy Spirit remain here and fill this place. We ask that in Jesus' name.